So for this episode, I'm here with Councillor Dawn Barnett for Hangleton and Knoll Ward on Brighton Hove City Council. Welcome, Dawn. I think it's your first time on the vote, isn't it?
It is.
So welcome.
It is. Yeah. Thank you.
I've got a lot to talk about. We're going to start off with Benfield Valley.
Mm-hmm.
Big issue here, planning issue. And I know that...
It's not a planning issue yet,
but it's a potential planning issue.
Yes.
Exactly. So just tell us what's going on at Benfield Valley, because I remember it back in the day when it was a golf course. I know it's now football golf, isn't it?
Yes, a man has taken, I think he rents it off of the family, and he does foot golf. I think it's quite busy at times, you know. But the thing with Benfield Valley, they want to start building houses on it. Once they start building, they say the first 100, it's opening a footway to get more than that. Over the years, we've fought them several times. They've wanted to have nightclubs up there. They wanted to have a hotel up there. The last thing was 800 houses, modular houses. That firm went bust. And previous, that there was a planning issue back in 2006, I think it was. I hadn't been a councillor long. They wanted to build homes on that. When they didn't get their own way, it got failed. They filled it up with travellers for the whole summer, and the family had to remove them at the end of the summer. I think they thought it was going to be to their advantage, but it cost them money to get rid of them in the end.
Yep.
And over the years, it's the planning keeps coming back and back and back, always for houses. I went over there a few weeks ago, and I saw one member of the family, and he said they can't afford, unless they get houses on it, to keep it going. So what I'd really like to see would be the council to take the lease back off of them. The lease originally was granted to Sainsbury's many, many years ago when Sainsbury's is there.
Yeah.
And obviously the family that are running the Benfield Valley now had a piece off of Sainsbury's. But if the council and the family would be prepared to let the lease go, if the council took the lease back off them, it would stay remain a green place for the residents of the whole of the city, not just for Hangleton and Knoll, but for the city. There's so much over there and there's so many groups that use it. We've got the wildlife group. They go out at 10:30 at night sometimes looking for slow worms.
Yeah.
Great groups of them. There's squirrels, there's badgers, there's foxes, there's buzzards. There's all the things, dormice even over there. Why disturb all that? Why not leave it exactly as it is? I'd like to see the South Downs take it as part of the South Downs Park.
Yeah.
And leave it as it is. There's the dog walkers. And sometimes the people over there are quite aggressive to the dog walkers because they wander off of the path. Well, when you've got a dog running, you can't always guarantee it's not going to step off the path, can you? And they get quite aggressive to the residents. But as I say, we don't want houses on it. We want it left as it is. It's the last green lung in Hove. And it should be there for everybody to enjoy. You can walk through to the Devil's Dyke. There's so much over there of interest. Schools go over there on occasions, not every week, but on occasions groups of school children go over there. And with children coming home from school, sitting in their bedrooms with a computer or watching the television, they need that for the weekends to go with their parents and explore, like everybody explored. The boys used to go exploring. You know, whether it's Wild Park or Benfield Valley, those places need to exist for the children and for the future generations.
Yeah, and it's near housing, isn't it, down there?
Pardon?
In the valley? It's very near housing.
Very near houses. When they wanted to put a hotel there, they wanted to back it onto the back of Meads Avenue's gardens with all the noise and they wanted hen nights and stag nights. Ludicrous. It's a tranquil place and it needs to be kept like that.
Yeah. So where are we at the moment then? People are just talking about it.
No, they're not talking about it. We had a petition going. We've got nearly 2,500 signatures. And I was promised in August that I would be allowed to bring my petition to council in October. In August, I only had 1,250 signatures. We now have nearly 2,500 to leave it as it is and be taken out of the city plan, part two.
Yeah, exactly. And it is part of the city plan at the moment, isn't it?
It is part of it, but we would like it removed from there. And it's not just me. There's people in Whitehall trying to save their land up by the stables. There's people in Coldean. You cannot keep taking every piece of green land because there is plenty of brownfield sites that can be used. They've got enough brownfield sites, and don't ask me where they all are, but there's enough brownfield sites to build sufficient houses and more besides without using green land.
Yeah. So what can be done then? Because what's happened with the petition so far?
Well, they've now refused, after a faithful promise, they've now refused to allow us to present our petition. And if you get more than 1,250, you can make a debate on council. You get 15 minutes to debate it. But they've said no. It's a planning petition, but it's not in planning. The City Plan Part 2 is still under consideration till the end of the month. So that is a load of rubbish. Yeah. It's not democratic. It's not at all democratic. They say they want to be democratic city. Then they need to let all three of our petitions go forward tomorrow.
Yeah, and that's when there's a full council meeting.
That is a full council meeting, and they should be allowed. The residents, they owe it to the residents to be able to speak and be able to speak up and not take it into their own hands to do exactly as they want, as they did with the Old Shore and Road Bike Lane.
Yeah. And it's not just the local residents that are going to be affected. I'm guessing there's going to be increased traffic in that area as well.
Of course there would be. Yeah. Of course. And when you come out of Port Slade, there is only two ways out of Port Slade, down through the village, yeah, onto the main road, or through into Hangleton. And through Hangleton, it's chaos now without building more.
Yeah, yeah. So, as well as the petition, what are local residents doing then? I know you've been active in the campaign. Who else is involved in the campaign?
Well, as I say, there's everybody involved. All the different groups that use it, the hedgehog people, the Benfield wildlife people, all the different individual groups, they're all behind it.
Yeah. So next steps then, I know there's a deadline, isn't there, for the consultation for people to...
End of the month.
So end of the month. So that's the 31st of October. So people listening can put forward their objections to the city plan too.
And it's all online. They've got to put their objections through. And the council have got to listen. They cannot go rough riding over everybody like they're doing. The city is being spoilt because nobody's getting a say. They're just doing exactly as they want.
Yeah. So, what else can be done with Benfield? I mean, how would you like Benfield Valley to? Would you like it to stay as it is, footy golf kind of?
I haven't got an objection against foot golf. Yeah. I've got an objection against building on it.
Yeah.
I would like to see it exactly as it is, or be taken over as part of the South Downs, and for the enjoyment of the residents of the city.
Yeah. What else can people do then to try and protect that piece of land? You're asking for the council to take it.
I'm asking for the council take the lease back. Yeah. It's a long lease, something like 250 years, and I don't know how much the family that are running it actually paid for it. I'm under the impression it was given to Sainsbury's.
Yeah.
So as to whether Sainsbury's sold part of it to the family that are running it, or whether that was also handed over. We're still waiting for answers for that. The council haven't got back to me on that.
Yeah.
But I would like to see the lease taken back off of them and left as it is for the enjoyment.
Yeah. Okay, and then if people want to find out more information, they should. Where can they go? They can go.
They can come to us. They can go online.
Yeah.
The petition's still running online.
Yeah.
As I say, we've got about... With what's online and with what we've got on paper, we've got about 2,400 and some odd.
Yeah. So we've got that. Moving on to Old Shoreham Road, I know you've been involved in the cycle lane there, Dawn. So just, and I have spoken to a range of councillors about it. What's your view? I know you've got a particular view, but there's growing objection to it, really, isn't there, within the council?
There is a growing objection to it. I mean, you can go the full length of Old Shoreham Road, you might see one person, and invariably they're riding on the pavement. It's chaos at the top of Olive Road. You're going along, people from Port Slade want to use the refuse place to take their hedge cuttings and things. Go along, you can't even turn into the tip, so you've got to go right down into Portland Road and back up Sackville Road to come in at an angle, and that's if you can get in. If not, you're sent away and you have to come back again. It's absolutely ludicrous. It needs to be removed. I'm not against cycle lanes, as most people aren't against cycle lanes, but what I am against is ones that aren't necessary. It's an arterial road, so it's got all the lorries going down to the harbour. It's got Marx's lorries, Sainsbury's lorries, all the big lorries. It's a danger. It's a danger to come out of Olive Road because you've got to cross the cycle lane to get into the line for the drivers. Yeah. And I have seen the traffic stacked up from Boundary Road traffic lights to the cemetery gates.
Yeah.
At certain times of the day.
Yeah.
Needs to be removed. They say it's temporary. How much more temporary can it be?
Yeah, and we can talk a bit more about that in the second half. So join us for the second half. We'll be speaking a lot more to Dawn Barnett, Councillor Dawn Barnett, for the Hangleton Knoll Ward in the second half. Join us then. So back here with Councillor Dawn Barnett for the second half of the vote, and we're going to be talking a bit more about cycle lanes. I've spoken to a lot of people about this, and your colleagues, Vanessa Brown, I've spoken to Lee Wares, Robert Nemeth, Sama Begin, but also from the Labour side, Jackie O'Quinn, who was talking about it yesterday. Cycle lanes, we're not saying, there's not really an argument against cycle lanes, it's about where they're at. Is that right?
That's right. That is exactly right. It doesn't need to be there. As I say, the majority of time they're riding on the pavement. In the really nice days, you used to see people using the cycle lane. But those cycle lanes, it's the same as the one on the seafront. Why have one on the road and one on the pavement? You know, they're taking up so much room, and they are crazy. It needs to be removed. There's so much people against it. There's so much blockage, the fumes, the congestion. It's not healthy. You stand up there in Old Shoreham and Mode of a night, you can smell the fumes and the diesel coming from the cars. It's not healthy to have it there, and it's not suitable to have it there. New Church Road would have been a better road. It's not an arterial road, and they could still cut up and go where they needed to go.
Yeah.
It would have been better in New Church Road.
Yeah.
But there's one on the seafront. People could use the ones on the seafront and cut up when they get to the area they need to go to.
Yeah, exactly. And I know you've spoken to local residents about that. I mean, it doesn't look like it's going to change anytime soon. We're going to have to wait till it's reviewed again. I think, is that later this year or maybe next year now when it comes up the committee again? Is that right?
Yeah.
So it'll be next year, you think?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So Hangleton and Knoll, tell us about what's going on in the ward there. I know that you've got, there's a lot of community work going on in that area.
Hangleton and Knoll is such a lovely place to live. It's got so much going on for it, for the elderly. There's different groups, there's lunch clubs, there's dance classes that are run by the doctor's surgery that are encouraging people to get mobile, and they come down, and we've, obviously it's had to stop at the moment. They come down, we've had people teaching them and dancing with them, the elderly, to get them active and give them somewhere to go, basically. I was lucky enough to get two donations to help it get started from different people, quite large donations. And they're all very generous. They're very nice, and you've got the Hangleton project that, I mean, there's computer classes going on this morning if people want to go and learn how to do a computer. We've got lunch clubs, we've got the Get Together Club that they have days out. It's such a lovely, lovely place, and there is such a lot going on.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, and we were just talking off stage about the kind of little shopping area there.
Yeah.
I mean, it's quite thriving, isn't it? It's done all right, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's thriving. There's a shop for everything up there, whether it's a butcher's, got a first-class butcher's, two Tesco's, Co-op, a betting office, the pub,
got a
the hairdressers.
Yeah.
You've got everything up there, a car maintenance shop. You've even got a car repair place hidden in the back of the shops.
Yeah.
It's got everything.
Yeah, and I know it's got a lot safer. You campaigned for the CCTV to be there, but was that ever, did that ever happen? Or
yes, we got a CCTV at the Grenadier.
Yeah, good. Yeah. So that's all good then. And what about the schools there? I know you've got some quite, Hove Park Lower School, where I went, got, down there. You've got Hangleton Junior School as well.
And Goldstone. Yeah. And now we've got the new school, Kings.
Yeah.
And
Where do you see the future of Hangleton then? I mean, has it changed over the years? Because I know you've lived there for a number of years. How have you seen the area change?
It's very family orientated now. I think there's not a lot more families than there used to be. It used to be quite a lot of elderly, but as these elderly people have passed over, young families have come in. Even the little close I live in, it was all elderly when I moved in there. We've now got families. I've got children next door to me, and there's a lot of little kids there riding their bikes, enjoying the close, and it's lovely to see.
Yeah. And what's your job consist of as a councillor? Because I know you're very active. So what's a normal day look like for Dawn Barnett at the moment? Because I know we're socially distanced. We had the coronavirus outbreak.
Yeah, but we're socially distanced in, but I've still got plenty on. You've got neighbourly disputes, people that need to either get a larger house or downsize. Benfield Valley, school places. You can make it a 24/7 job, and I choose to. I love what I do. I love being active, keeps me going.
Yeah.
As I say, you can make it. I've been called out before now at 3 a.m, but I don't mind because that's what I was elected to do.
Yeah.
And I just thoroughly enjoy it.
Yeah, and I can see that. And how long have you been a councillor for, Dawn?
Since 2004.
So it's a long, it's changed.
16 now. Yeah, 16 years.
What have you seen changed then in Brighton and Hove City Council? It's always good and bad in any city, isn't there, really?
I think people are a lot more aware of things where they used to accept things. They've now decided to fight back, i.e. Benfield Valley, the cycle lanes. Once upon a time, they would have just said, if it's going to happen, it's going to happen. They're prepared to fight back now to get what they want. They're prepared to fight to keep the neighbourhood clean. Whereas once upon a time, like the parks, people would accept the swings broken. Now it's, can we get the swing mended? We need this, we need that. They're more forceful to get, in a nice way, not nasty. They fight more for what is nice.
Yeah.
And that's what keeps Hangleton as a lovely place.
Yeah, and it is beautiful, particularly the valley area. It is beautiful.
It is lovely, Hangleton. Yeah. And I don't find any problems with the council. If I approach city parks or anybody, I usually get answers and that something is acted on. If I phone up about, I've got an issue in Hangleton Valley Drive where the weeds are coming through the pavements, phone up City Parks, City Clean, and they're going to send somebody round because I've got a lot of elderly round there that are frightened of slipping. And they do it, you know.
Yeah.
There's a lot good about the council, but there's a lot that's not good with the not being democratic.
And that's what council's for, isn't it?
That's right.
It does go down to the bins, and because people often write to their member of parliament, and actually a lot of those issues that people write to an MP about, really, they just delegate it down to a councillor, don't
they? That's right,
So it's good. I mean, that's always the first port of call, isn't it, really?
Yes,
councillor should be.
And the thing is, people phone up and they all phone me because they know me and they say, "Hi, Dawn, it's Sheila. Can you come and see me?" And I think, which Sheila? You know? Everybody's your friend and everybody thinks you're their best friend.
Exactly.
I have one or two of the elderly come in and knock on the door and say, "Got a cup of tea?" Because a lot of the groups are finished at the moment because of COVID. But I've got one or two people that pop round my house and would like a cup of tea just to have someone to chat to because the elderly get lonely.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. Yeah. So are you doing a lot of stuff via Zoom? Do you have regular surgery? I know you
well,
do it.
Well, they can't. I have a surgery every third Friday in the month at St Richard's Church. Nick Lurie has a surgery every fourth Friday at the community centre, but we can't do them at the moment because of the... But people have got their phone numbers. They're always on the phone, or they stop you in Sainsbury's, or stop you as you're walking around the streets.
Yeah.
You know, so things are getting done up there.
Yeah, exactly. And where's your ward, before we finish up, where is it? Because your ward, it does include Townsville Valley, which Until it fairly recently, I wasn't.
You wouldn't have thought.
You would never. You'd think that would be Hove Park Ward, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
But for some reason, do we know why it was part of Hangleton?
No, it's always been part of Hangleton. My ward starts at Portslade Station, coming up from one side of the road, on the right hand side, coming up from Portslade Station, up all around Hangleton Valley Drive, up to where the Devil's Diet railway track started, and all round Harmsworth Crescent, the very top of Hangleton, all round part of the Bishop of Hannington Church, and down to the bottom of Holmes Avenue. I've got 6,500 houses up there.
So it's a big patch, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a big patch.
And it's a big mix up there, isn't it?
I've got three lots of social housing with some lovely people in them.
Yeah.
I've got a few that spoil it for others.
Yeah.
And I've got a lot of what I would call more affluent people. It's two totally different groups, but there's no animosity. Why should there be?
Yeah, exactly, yeah. What else has come up on the doorstep then? What other issues? I mean, it's always normally bins. I know there's been some issues with the green there near the church, near Hangleton Valley Drive.
That's right, yeah. St Helen's Green.
St Helen's Green,
That gets a bit wild at times, but they've got this big machine they go round with to cut the grass, but it doesn't get near enough to the trees to get under the trees to cut what's left. And it was all left to grow really wild.
Yeah.
But they have been up, given their due, they've been up, they've cleared it all, because the people were letting their dogs go to the toilet in the long grass.
Yeah.
But they have come up, they've cut all around the trees for me with a smaller machine, and it looks really nice.
Yeah, great, okay. Well, even if now, how can people contact you? Do they just get via email or...?
They can phone me, or they can send me an email, or they can stop me in the shops.
Yeah.
Or anywhere they see me out and about.
Brilliant.
I've always got a notepad.
Yeah, okay, great. That's good to know.
And I'm quite happy for them to phone me or stop me.
Brilliant. We'll leave it there, Dawn. It's been a joy. All the best with... I know you've got
with
a full council meeting coming up. And with the Benfield Valley site as well, and people can go online and find out about that.
Yep.
And we'll keep posting that. We'll chat to you again soon. So thanks for coming in today.
And thanks for having me.
Thanks.
All right.